Hello, I'm Steve Mueller, the CEO of Surveillant, and this is my favorite room in the building, our Customer Solutions Center. Here we have five different technologies that we're demonstrating, some of which are in use today, others which we expect to be in use in the future. Behind me, we have our SCADA OMS and DMS working together in a very tightly integrated demo solution. In front of me, we have our collaboration table. This is where a utility will work when they have major events or major storms, and they have many, many people working together to try and correct or evaluate problems and deliver solutions and take actions. We also have virtual reality, HoloLens, which we believe will be the control room technology of the future. We have a working microgrid in here, which includes a weather station up on the roof and solar panels in a carport charging station right outside. And then finally, we have a distribution automation application solution with real live switch gear so that it acts very, very similar to what you would see in a distribution utility. One of the technologies that I mentioned earlier was our microgrid. And I'm sitting here at our microgrid, which consists of a weather station up on the roof, solar panels on a carport charger out in our parking lot. Also have an inverter, which is kind of the brains of the whole microgrid. We have backup DC batteries. We have our relay rack, which is providing all the communication and the CPU for our HMI. So let's take a look and see how we're doing. So I'll go up to the weather station, and I see a very, very good radiation figure, which makes sense because we have a bright sunny day, no clouds, and we're fairly close to the summer solstice. All right, let's take a look and see where all that power is going. We're producing about 8 kilowatts, and to put that in context, the building here, a day like today, is going to peak around 500 kilowatts. So on a good day, we only provide about 2% of what the building needs from the solar panels. Now, where is that power going? Well, some of it is going to power the actual racks, the communication, and the CPUs that's driving the HMI. Some of it is going back, 2 kilowatts is going back to Electra, which is our grid provider, and then a small amount is going to charge the DC batteries. I'm at the distribution automation simulation demonstration area, and this is one of the technologies that we talked about in the introduction. This is probably the neatest thing we have here because we have real live G&W switchgear. The same switchgear that you would actually have out in the field at a distribution utility. And they're hooked up with motor operators, relays, all communicating back to the Surveillant master station. And this is the one line diagram that we have. We have two substation sources, and we have a bunch of switches, and we have a bunch of areas where we can put in a mock fault current. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a fault in right here at C, and I'm gonna lose that line right there, and we're gonna watch how Surveillant technology reconfigures and restores power to as much of the grid as it possibly can. And here we go. So I'm down C and D sections. I'm gonna open on each side of the fault, and then I'm gonna close in another source, and I restore D, which happens to be the data center load. And that was the final technology that we were going to show to you today. Thanks so much for joining us. I hope you found it of interest, and we look forward to working with you in the future.